Welcome to Frank's School, 169th day of the fourth year. Third video, one that I didn't expect I was going to make, but I really felt that I had to. I believe it or not, I don't like to present myself talking any more than I have to. You may laugh at that, but I think that I need to say a little bit about what's coming in the next video, the fourth and then the fifth. The convent of Christ, convento de Cristo, at Tomah. Oh, and there's an R there. In the last time I spoke, I was saying it, but I didn't have it written on the board. This is a UNESCO World Heritage Site, and it certainly deserves to be there. This was Thomas's favorite, he said at one point. He said of the whole trip, this was what he was most impressed with. I'd have to say Thomas has good taste. We missed the Pegoise aqueduct. I filmed the very end of it where it arrives at the castle, at the convento. But so you see a little bit of it. But you know, you can only do so much in one trip, and I sort of knew about it, but it was not my principal reason for going to Tomah. I went to Tomah because a woman named Claudia back in Lisbon had told me that there was the equivalent of abyss. Well, she may have been referring to the aqueduct itself. I'm just not sure. and I'm not sure I'm going to go back. But the Pegoise aqueduct is worth searching. Just type that into Google and click on it. Some YouTube videos or whatever. It's spectacular. And Shirley had said as well, if we knew about it, we could have gone there. We did have time, but we were just so much of the time working on overload that we missed it. It's too bad. I think I would have loved to see it. This was built by the Knights Templar, and there's something also worth researching. I'm not ready to go into an explanation of those Knights Templar, but with the Da Vinci Code, they became popular lately. So, you know, look at it, research it if you want. Pretty amazing stuff. The Hawklings and I make a false start in the video. You'll see us, we start around the castle wall and then come back. And then we went to the main entrance. But I don't regret that because I got to see the stonework. The word hand workers record. I'm not sure what to call that. Versus history. I find myself very sensitive to it. The work that people have left, the hand workers, the stonemasons, the woodworkers, the terrace builders, you know, nobody knows their names. Nothing's written, but they leave a record with what they did with their hands. And I found myself thinking about that. What a record has been left there by the hands and muscles of the people that built that. Versus history. You know, we make so much of history. Well, history is about, you know, one definition of it is it's from the time of the beginning of writing. That's what history is, writing. It's about words. It's about written words. But then there's another kind of a record that I think is not, well, maybe it's right that words don't cover it very well because it's not about words. It's about what people have done, and then you see what they've done. I'm jumping around here a little bit, but the wood turning, for example, I wouldn't want to do that with wood myself, but nonetheless, it's unbelievable. You know, wood turning is what you do on a lathe. At one point, I see an organ pipe, and I'm surprised. You know, I say, is that an organ pipe? And I've thought a little bit more about that. What's one organ pipe doing in there? Well, you know, I later learned that building has 16 sides. Well, maybe there were 16 notes. Maybe there was an organ in there. Well, 16 notes would be plenty to play most pieces. But where would you get the wind to power an organ pipe that big? Maybe it played very softly. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I mean, it's one of those things that you could research or I could research. Undercroft, I wrote that in there. I think that's the right term for it. When you go in an area that's got those stone vaults over it, and there's clearly a floor above it, that's called an undercroft. Now there's also the really high ones in cathedrals, the high vaults, but when they're low like that, I think that's called an undercroft, and you'll see them. Well, it's amazing, just amazing that, and I really think I needed to stop and make some comment about that. You'll see in Shirley's slideshow, which I'll put on as the fifth video of this day, you'll see her view of this spectacular place. Well, then the next one, I think it'll be the sixth, and I don't think I'll interrupt with my speaking, but you'll see the water wheel at Tomar, which was one of the reasons that I wanted to go there in the first place, to see the waterworks down there, and then back to Lisbon. So I think that'll come before I speak again, I think. Bye for now.